हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. एम आई ऑडिबल? ओके ओके, थैंक यू. ओके, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर मैथमेटिक्स 1, एंड दिस इज द कोड ऑफ अवर सब्जेक्ट, दैट इज 3110014. ओके, एंड before going to start our lecture, I want to share you the syllabus of our mathematics 1, that is, as per the GTU, our credit, subject credit is 5 here, and the examination marks, 70 marks for the external exam and 30 marks for the internal exam out of 100, total 100 marks, right? Total 6 units are there. First unit, that is indeterminate form and L'Hospital rule. In that, improper integrals and application of some integrals are there that contain 15% weightage. Unit 2, that is of sequence and series, that contain 20% weightage. Unit 3 is Fourier series, that contain 10%. Unit 4, that is the function of several variables, that contain 20%. Unit 5 of multiple integral, that is for 20% weightage. And for the unit 6, it is from the matrix, okay, it contain 15% weightage. So total 6 units are there. We are continue our today's lecture with unit 3, that is Fourier series, right? So let's continue with the Fourier series, that is, okay. So first, what is Fourier series? Start with the series. If any function, suppose we take a function, exponential function, that is e raised to x, right? So if we keep this e raised to x as 1 plus x plus x square by 2 factorial plus x cube by 3 factorial up to so on, then we can say that the left hand side is function, exponential function, and right hand side is exponential function, but it is in the form of series. If we represent any function in the form of summation more and more than two terms, then we can say that it is in the form of series. So suppose trigonometric function, that is sine x, so we can represent this trigonometric function in the series form, like x minus x cube by 3 factorial plus x raised to 5 by 5 factorial minus up to so on. So dear students, this is called series. Okay, now this type of series we represent with the help of Taylor series, Maclaurin series theorem, etc. also. But why we are doing this Fourier series, or why we are applying this Fourier series to any functions? Because other methods are applicable for non-periodic functions only. Okay, other methods are applicable for non-periodic functions, but the Fourier series is applicable for periodic functions too, non-periodic and periodic functions too. So for the periodic functions, if we want to represent a periodic functions in the form of series, then we apply Fourier series. Okay, so this is first why we are learn this Fourier series. So we will learn this Fourier series because if any students want to represent any periodic functions in the form of series, then he or she will apply this method. Okay, so let's start with the definition of the periodic function. So what is periodic function? A function f of x is said to be periodic with period t greater than 0 if f of x plus t is equal to f of x, for all real number x, and t is called a period of f. Example, suppose sin x is a periodic function with period 2 pi. Hence, sin x is equal to sin x plus 2 pi. It means if we add the period in its theta, then there will be no change in the value of the functions. Similarly, cos x is also a periodic function with period 2 pi. So we represent cos x is equal to cos x plus 2 pi, right? So if t is any period of for any function f of x, suppose t is any period for any given function f of x, then f of x is equal to f of x plus t, f of x plus 2t, f of x plus 3t, up to so on. It means 2t, 3t, 4t, this is capital T, 4t also called the period of the functions f of x, and the smallest of all these is called primitive, or we can say it is the fundamental period of f of x. So students, these are the some graphs for the better understanding of the period. This is the first graph with period 2 pi. So this is the graph of sin x with period 2 pi. This is the starting point, here our period 2 pi. Similarly, for the second one, this is the graph of cos x, right? Second one, this is the graph of cos x. So for the graph is for the cos x, this is here again the period is 0 to 2 pi. The next one, graph A with period 2 pi. This is for period 2 pi. This one is the here, this, see, this is starting point 0. This is period 2 pi. For graph B, this one 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is for 0 to 4. So graph B for period 4, graph C for period 6, and graph D for period 2. So this is for your better understanding only. No need for the solution of the example, right? Now let's move with some most important formula which we will use in the solution of the example. This is the most important formulas for the Fourier series example. That is the integration by parts. And as you know, if u and v are functions of x, then integration of u dot v dx, that is u integration of v dx minus integration of d by dx of u into integration of v dx into dx, right? Into dx here. Right? Now, for the selection of u and v, Eilert rule is there, L for the logarithmic, I for inverse, A for algebraic, T for trigonometric, and E for exponential, which you have already applied in your school lectures, right? So, now the next, this is the most important, this is the generalized rule. This is the generalized rule for the integration of uv. Generalized rule, that is Leibniz rule. Here, integration of uv with respect to x, that is u dot v1 minus u dash v2. See, the students, this is the most important. So please be careful here. Integration of uv dx, u keep it same. V1, that is the integration of v, minus derivative of u, that is u dash. Integration of v1, that is v2, plus u double dash, that is the derivative of u dash. V3, that is the integration of v2, up to so on. As I told you, our first term is plus, second one is minus, plus minus, okay, that way. Here dashish indicates derivative and suffix indicates integrals. Dashish, u dash means du by dx, u double dash means d square u by dx square, u triple dash is cube u upon dx cube up to so on. Similarly, this v1 indicates this is the integral. So v1, that is the integration of v, but v2, this is the integration of v1. So if we have v3, then that is the integration of v2. Suppose we have v4, so that is the integration of v3 up to so on. So this is the generalized rule, or we can say this is the Leibniz rule for the integration, which we will apply in the solution of Fourier series examples, right? Now, the convergence of Fourier series, or we can say Dirichlet condition. So what is this Dirichlet condition? Dirichlet condition is for if we have given any function f of x, we can apply or not Fourier series on these functions. So if our functions satisfy this Dirichlet condition, then and only then we apply Fourier series formula on that example. Suppose a function f of x can be represented by complete set of orthogonal functions. Orthogonal means the product of that functions, both functions are perpendicular to each other, right? Within the interval, our function is periodic, so this is our period, C2, C plus 2pi. First condition is f of x, our given function must be periodic, right? So it is periodic. Example, suppose f of x is equal to f of x plus 2l, where 2l is the period of the given function f of x. Second condition, f of x and its integrals are finite and single value. Means functions and its integral, both are finite and single value. They should not be multi-value. F of x has finite number of discontinuity. It means if our given function f of x is equal to, suppose x 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi by 2 and sub equal to x, pi by 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi is equal to x square, pi less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2 pi. It means period of our given function is 0 to 2 pi, but there are some discontinuity. Our function is discontinue at pi by 2 and at pi. So this discontinuities, f of x has finite number of discontinuity, okay? So this discontinuity should be finite. And the third condition is f of x has a finite number of maximae. Fourth condition is f of x has a finite number of maximae minima. Means our function satisfied all these conditions, then we apply the Fourier series formula and we find the Fourier series for that functions. Students, in our course, all functions are set, functions satisfy Dirichlet conditions. So you do not have to panic, or you do not have to do find the functions satisfy this formula or not. We have only that functions given which satisfy this condition, Dirichlet condition. So we just have to apply formula for that function and find the answer. Okay. Now, what are the formula of the Fourier series? The formulas are, this is the Fourier series of a periodic function f of x with period 2 pi. In the interval C2, C plus 2 pi, this is our period. This is the trigonometric series. See, this is the main formula of the Fourier series. for the period c to c plus 2 pi. Students, this is f of x, is this is our function f of x, series in the form of a0 by 2 plus summation n 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx. It means our functions, when we convert into the Fourier series, that series in the form of cos nx and in the form of sin nx. Now this a0, an, and bn are Fourier coefficients constant, are Fourier coefficients constant, and it is defined by a0 equal to 1 by pi c to c plus 2 pi f of x dx, an 1 by pi c to c plus 2 pi f of x cos nx dx, and bn 1 by pi c to c plus 2 pi f of x sin nx dx. Students, here the limits are same, c to c plus 2 pi, 1 by pi is also same, but for a0 fx only, for an fx cos nx, and for bn fx sin nx. See, this four formula, this is the more generalized formula, this is the formula for the coefficient constant a0, an, bn. In every example we will apply this formula, so this is the most important for you for the Fourier series chapter, so you have to remember this formula. Except this formula you cannot solve any example of Fourier series. Okay, so please keep in mind all these four formula, first, second, third and fourth. Now some important values are there, that is cos 0 1, sin 0, sin pi, sin 2 pi, sin 2n pi, sin l pi, all sin pi and sin 0 gives value 0. Cos 0 1, cos pi minus 1, cos 2 pi 1, cos 2n pi is also 1, and cos n pi is minus 1 raised to n. Please keep these important values in your mind, which will help us in the solution of the example. And the more two formula, that is e raised to ax cos bx dx is equal to e raised to ax upon a square plus b square a cos bx plus b sin bx, and the other one is e raised to ax sin bx dx is equal to e raised to ax upon a square plus b square a sin bx minus b cos bx. Okay, so these are the formula which we will apply in the example. So let's start with the most easy example of the Fourier series, that is obtain Fourier series to represent f of x is equal to x in the interval 0 less than x less than 2 pi. Okay, so now obtain Fourier series to represent f of x is equal to x in the interval 0 less than x less than 2 pi. Yogesh and Krupen, hide your video. So let's start with the formula. Our formula is f of x is equal to a0 by 2 plus summation n 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx. Okay, now what is, see, this is the most general formula and you have to remember for every example. Again I repeat, f of x is equal to a0 by 2 plus summation n 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx. Now we have to apply formula of a0, an and bn. By applying these three formula and finding the value, and after that we have to substitute all these three value in this formula. That is, for a0, formula of a0 is what? 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi f of x dx. Why we are applying here 0 to 2 pi? Because our given limits or our given period is 0 to 2 pi. As we know that our formula is c to c plus 2 pi. Here for c is equal to 0, if we take here c is equal to 0, then that is 0 to 2 pi. So our given limits or given period is 0 to 2 pi. So in the formula we apply for 0 to 2 pi f of x dx. Now what is our function? Our function is x, right? So 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi, this one is x dx. Okay, now the integration of this x with respect to dx, that is x square by 2 0 to 2 pi, right? Now just a minute, sorry students, some technical error is again there, so I will write the solution again. That is a0, sorry, our main formula is f of x is equal to a0 by 2 plus summation n 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx, right? Now for a0, 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi f of x dx. So 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi f of x is x dx. So by the integration, here 1 by pi x square by 2, here 0 to 2 pi. So after 2 pi, so after substituting the upper limits, if I take 2 as a common, 4 pi square wait a minute, Mohammed, who is this? See, in book there is a0 is equal to a by 2 pi, but Mohammed, here in book, in your general formula, that there is a0 only, but here I am taking a0 by 2, so I am taking here 1 by pi only. Okay, so both are right. Here I am taking 1 by pi for a0, so in general formula I put a0 by 2, but in book they take 1 upon 2 pi, so in general formula they are taking a0 only. Okay, now understand? Okay. So students, if I keep 2 as a common and x square upper limit, if I apply x square for upper limit, that is 4 pi square, that is 4 pi square. Just a minute. -0, right? And after simplification, my answer is 2 pi. So value of a0 is what? 2 pi. Okay. Now value of a0 is 2 pi. Now if I apply an, then formula of an is 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi f of x cos nx dx. For an, f of x cos nx dx. Okay, so 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi. Here function f of x is what? What is our function? Our given function f of x is x. So we are applying x cos nx dx, right? So for the UV rule, if I take x as a u and cos nx as v, so x keep it same. Integration of this cos nx is what? Sin nx upon n minus the derivative of x is 1. Integration of this sin nx upon n is minus cos nx upon n square, right? And the limits are 0 to 2 pi. Okay. Now, 1 by pi, if I apply the upper limit, this is 2 pi. And here, sin, if I keep here 2 pi, that is sin 2n pi, right? Upon n, minus minus plus cos 2n pi upon n square. This is for the upper limit. If I apply the lower limit, then for the lower limit, 0 into sin 0, 0 into anything is 0, so this is 0, minus minus plus cos 0 upon n square, right? So this is for the lower limit. So as you know, the values of this function, that is sin 2n pi, this is n, this one is pi. So sin 2n pi is 0, 0 into anything is 0. So 0 plus cos 2n pi is 1, so 1 upon n square, minus 0, cos 0 is 1, so 1 upon n square, right? After simplification, we have 1 upon n square plus minus minus 1 upon n square. So our answer will be 0. So answer for an is 0. Okay. Here a0 is 2 pi, an is 0. Now the third and last coefficient constant, that is bn. And the formula for bn is 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi f of x sin nx dx. Okay, so 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi f of x is x sin nx dx. So the integration of this integral is x, keep it same. Integration of sin nx is cos nx, minus cos nx upon n, minus the derivative of x is 1. The integration of this minus cos nx is minus sin nx upon n square, and the derivative of 1 is 0, so no need to write the other terms. So here 0, limits are 0 to 2 pi. After substituting the upper limits and lower limits, if I put upper limit, that is 2 pi here, minus cos 2n pi upon n, this minus minus plus sin 2n pi upon n square, right? Minus for the lower limit, 0 into anything is 0 plus sin 0 upon n square. So 1 by pi, this 2 pi, cos 2n pi is 1, so minus 1 upon n plus 0, minus this 0 and sin 0 is again 0, so both the value 0. After simplification, both pi will be cancelled, so our answer is for bn is minus 2 by n. Students, this is the most easy example of Fourier series. Our given function is f of x. This is the generalized formula of the Fourier series. This is a0 by 2 plus summation n 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx. Then after, we have to find these three coefficient constant, first a0, then an and bn. So first we find a0, the value of a0 is 2 pi. Value of an is 0 and value of bn is minus 2 by n. Now Again, we have to write this this generalized formula, that is a0 by 2 summation n 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx. Okay, now we have to substitute all three values in this formula. Here, what is our given function? Given function f of x is x. What is the value of a0? That is 2 pi by 2 summation n 1 to infinity. Value of a0, which we have find, that is 0, right? Cos nx. And value of bn, that is minus 2 by n sin nx, right? Now both 2 will be cancelled. Here pi, 0 into cos nx is 0, so minus 2 by n, if I keep minus 2 common, summation n 1 to infinity sin nx upon n. Okay, now if I keep n 1 to infinity, if I keep, we'll start with the 1, then sin 1x upon 1, that is sin x upon 1. If then 2, that is sin 2x upon 2, then sin 3x upon 3. Here n running from 1 to infinity, so we'll start with the 1 only. Here sin x upon 1, we keep 1, 2, 3 up to infinity in the place of n. So sin x upon 1, sin 2x upon 2, sin 3x upon 3 up to infinity, so on. So this is our given function x, and our limits or our period is 0 to 2 pi. So we represent this function x in the period 0 to 2 pi in the form of Fourier series, that is pi minus 2 sin x plus sin x, sin 2x by 2 plus sin 3x by 2, 3 up to so on. So students, this way we will convert more functions in the form of Fourier series in next lectures also. If you have any doubt, then you can ask me in chat box or raise your hand. If you have any doubt, then ask me through chat box or raise your hand. Ishika, yeah, this is the answer. No, now this is the answer. No need to solve summation. Okay, no need to solve summation. This is the answer. You want to show the formulas? Okay, okay, I will share the formulas. See, this is the formula. Abhay, this is the main formula. F of x a0 by 2 summation n 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx. Okay, then this is for a0, this is for an, and this one for bn. In all example we will use this. Which condition, ma'am? Please explain the condition. Munil, which condition do you ask for? The Dirichlet condition. Okay, I explain the Dirichlet condition again, but Munil, that condition is not useful to you for the solution of this example. Okay, as I told, you have already given only that functions which satisfied Dirichlet condition. So no need to use of this condition for the solution of the example. This is for your knowledge only. Okay. First condition, our first condition is function should be periodic. Second condition is function and its integrals are finite and single value. Third, function has finite number of discontinuity. And the fourth, function has finite number of maxima and minima. Okay, so this condition is for your knowledge only. It will not be helpful for the solution of the example for our GTU exam. Okay, anyone else? Have you any query? Okay, so yes, okay. So if you have any students, in tomorrow's lecture we will continue this topic with the more functions. Our today's lecture, that is for the introduction of Fourier series. In today's lecture we learn why we are using Fourier series. I explain again, we are using Fourier series because if we want to convert if we want to convert any periodic function into the series, trigonometric series form, then we use Fourier series. Students, for the assignment today, very shortly you will get the assignment, and you have to solve. If you have any query, then you can contact me through our chat box or through our lectures. Okay, today only you will get your assignment. Okay, very soon you get your assignment. Cover page of book. Okay, wait a minute. Just a minute. Students, tomorrow I will share the cover page of book. Okay, anything else? Okay, so you can leave today's lecture. We'll continue our lecture tomorrow with the more example.